In this video, we'll draw the Lewis structure for the NO3- ion. This is the nitrate ion. We'll also look at the molecular geometry, bond angles, and a bit about resonance. So the first thing we need to do to draw the NO3- Lewis structure, we need to count up the valence electrons. So we have the periodic table here. Each group has the number of valence electrons listed. We skip the transition metals. We're looking for nitrogen. Here it is. Group 15, sometimes called 5A. Five valence electrons for nitrogen. For oxygen, that's right here, that's in group 16, sometimes called 6A. It has six valence electrons. We have three oxygen atoms multiplied by three, and this negative sign up here, that means we have an extra electron, so we have one more there. That gives us a total of 24 valence electrons for the NO3- Lewis structure. We'll put the least electronegative element in the center of our Lewis structure, that's the nitrogen, and then we'll put three oxygen atoms around it. We have a total of 24 valence electrons for the NO3- Lewis structure. Let's put a pair of electrons between atoms. This will form the chemical bond. Once we've done that, we can put pairs of electrons around each oxygen here to complete its octet until we've used 24 valence electrons. So at this point, we've used 24 valence electrons. Each oxygen atom has eight. That's an octet. The problem is that this central nitrogen atom here, it only has 2, 4, 6 valence electrons. It needs eight to have an octet. What we could do is move a pair of electrons between the oxygen and the nitrogen here to form a double bond. When we do that, this oxygen still has eight, but now the nitrogen, it has eight. So everything has an octet. This is the Lewis structure for the NO3- ion, the nitrate ion. If we check the formal charges here, they'll look like this. We'd prefer to have them closer to zero. We do need a negative one to match the charge here on the nitrate ion. We would prefer that these would be closer to zero, but there's really no way we can do that. If we move this pair here to form a double bond and reduce the formal charges, now nitrogen has 10 valence electrons, so that doesn't work. That makes this the best Lewis structure for NO3-. We do need to put brackets around this since it's an ion, then put a negative charge out here. Let's remove our formal charges. So this is our Lewis structure for the nitrate ion. Note we've used all 24 valence electrons. Let's take a look at the molecular geometry and resonance just briefly. So we can consider the purple here our nitrogen. We'll add the two oxygens that are single bonded, 1, 2. You see they spread out, so they're far away as they can from each other. Then that double bond, and there are no lone pairs. So we end up with this planar molecular geometry for NO3-. It's called trigonal planar. And if we look at the bond angles here between atoms, they're 120 degrees. So this is our molecular geometry for NO3-, the nitrate ion. The electron geometry, since there aren't any lone pairs, that would just be trigonal planar as well. Let's go back to our Lewis structure. Since we have this double bond here and single bonds, we will have resonance. And we could have drawn this with the double bond here, or here, or like we have it here. So we have three resonance structures. They look like this. So these are the major resonance structures for NO3-. We have a double bond here on this one. It's over here and over here. In reality, the actual structure for NO3- would be an average of these. So we'd end up with something that looks like this here, where these bonds here between the oxygens and nitrogens, they're an average from these three resonance structures. So that's the Lewis structure, molecular geometry, bond angles, and resonance for the NO3- Lewis structure, the nitrate ion. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.